Now, I want to talk about this situation a little deeper because look at what is reported here. In 2010, the statue received a $4 million renovation repair parts of its face and hands that had been badly eroded. Now, why am I talking about this? Because there is so much poverty in Brazil, so much poverty. People are living in the favelas. It is literally such a low quality lifestyle, yet they are splashing $4 million on repairing a statue. Now, this is not actually Jesus Christ.
See, that's another thing, man. If you do your research, majority of the places, man, that got these Jesus statues, man, they put it up there as for like a good luck charm, that like God would bless this nation. No matter how we live our life, we got the statue up there, so God sees the statue and he's going to bless the country. It don't work like that. Majority of these places like Mexico and Brazil and a whole lot of these other countries that got these Jesus statue, Google that country and see the condition of that country. That country is a poor country. They starving. They're not doing good at all. So the thing is, what is the statue doing? It ain't doing nothing. Absolutely nothing. That does not please God. And we're going to learn why that don't please God in a minute. But that don't please God. So the thing is, this country is poor, and look at the leaders, the government in this country. They took $4 million. Instead of giving money to the poor and feeding the poor and helping the poor people, they took that money and spent $4 million to fix the hand on this statue that don't mean nothing to God. Ain't that something? You know what? I could believe that they did that too. Because when you think about America, you think about America, and you see in America that we have poor people on every corner. It's gotten to the point like every exit I get off, people are out there begging for money. When you go through California, man, it's like a third world country, right? You got all these tents up there for miles and miles and miles of homeless people sleeping in the streets. When you look at with Kensington in Philadelphia, the place where I used to go to, you see there's so much poor people out there, and they're living in the streets. And this is all around America. America is really at the end where they're getting to be a third world country. That's how poor this country is, because it's getting cursed. It's not blessed like it used to be because we turn our backs on God. But anyway, we see these things, but the government, instead of raising money to fix this by getting people off the streets, building homes that these people won't be poor, helping these people get off of drugs, instead of them putting money into that, they'll scrape up $100 billion and send it to Ukraine. Really? I never knew that Ukraine was the 51st state. I knew we had 50 states, but I didn't know we had one added, Ukraine. Because that's how it is. It seems like you're taking care of one of your own, and that's not your own. You're sending billions and billions of our money that we didn't approve. You didn't even ask us. You didn't get the green light from us. We didn't have to vote. Shouldn't we have to vote on that? Because we the ones that's got to pay it back through our taxes. You're digging into our money and go spend it the way you want, but then we got to pay for it later. That's how it really is. And that's the government doing it to us. The government don't care about the people in America. They care more about the people in Ukraine, because they have an agenda, a secret agenda. Amen. So I could believe that the leaders in Rio de Janeiro did that. Because here it is. We're mad. This government has made statements against Russia because they say Russia is invading Ukraine's border, and that's not right. But yet and still, you don't take care of our border, and you allow enemies, and who we don't even know all the enemies that's around the world that hates us, that's infiltrated inside this country. Number one, we're letting fentanyl come in this country and destroy hundreds and hundreds of thousands of Americans, and we won't fix our borders, we won't protect our borders. But you want to worry about Ukraine's borders? This is crazy, man. But anyway, that's why I say I could believe that the leaders in Brazil did that, because I could see that our leaders do the same thing to us. So let's see how God feels about statues, graven images, which are idols. Look what God said. We're gonna speed read through this because I want you to go back later and read over the scriptures that we're going to. But I want to show you from the beginning what God said about graven images, which is statues, which is also considered as idols. He said, we're in Exodus chapter 20. I'm going to read 1 through 5. I'm going to read through it fast. I'm going to explain it a little bit, but I want you later to go back and reread it yourself. Take the time to read through it. So in Exodus 20, look at starting verse 1. It said, and God spoke all these words saying, I am the Lord thy God. Let me give you a little quick history. God had just delivered the children of Israel out of slavery, out of Egypt. He brought them into the wilderness. While they're in the wilderness, he has promised them that he's going to bring them into Canaan. Canaan is going to be their America. That's going to be their America, where it's going to be. He called Canaan a land of milk and honey, meaning that this place is going to be nice. They're going to have nice homes and everything. God is going to bring them into that place like how he brought us into America and blessed this country. Because that land that he's bringing them into, which is Canaan, later on became Israel. And that's the Israel today. Amen. So he says, and God spoke all these words saying, this, he's talking to them in the wilderness. He's gathering them up. He already delivered them out of Egypt. He already delivered them out of the hands of Pharaoh. He already set them free. They're no longer in slavery anymore. And God is now giving them instruction, because that's what God does. God gives rules. He gives ordinances. He gives instructions, right? He says, I am the Lord thy God, which have brought thee out of the land of Egypt. Remind you, I am God, and I'm the one that brought you out of the land of Egypt, out of the house of bondage. Verse 3, he said, look what he's saying now. He's laying rules down. He's setting standards. He said, thou shalt have no other gods before me. I'm your God. There should be no other God before you. I'm your master. You shouldn't listen to nobody else but me. That's what he's saying. Verse 4. He said, thou shalt not make unto thee any graven image or any likeness of anything that is in heaven above, or that is in the earth beneath, or that is in the water under the earth. Thou shalt not bow thyself down to them, nor serve them, for I am the Lord your God, am a jealous God. Look what God said. God said, thou shalt not make unto thee any graven in an image. Anything that you had to, you just made a graven image, which is a statue, right? That's an image, and it's a graven image because men took their little tools and engraved it. You know, they sharpened it and fashioned it. He says, and God said, you should not do that. He said, you should not make unto thee any graven image or any likeness of anything that is in heaven above or in the earth beneath. That Jesus statue is a graven image, and it's in the likeness of something that is in heaven above, which is Jesus. Jesus is in heaven above, and we got this statue that is made in the likeness of something that is in heaven above, right? And God said, don't do that. And you might say, well, no, you know, it's a statue. It's a graven image of him when he was down on earth. Well, he said out here on earth too. He said, or in the likeness of anything that is in heaven above or that is in the earth beneath. God hit all rims, the heavenly rim, the earthly rim, and even under the water, even the water rim. He letting you know, not even in the water. You don't make any image of anything that is in the heavens, the earth, or down in the sea. No image. I don't need no fish images. I don't need no shark images. I don't need none of those graven images. I don't need it, right? So he said, thou should not bow thyself down to them, nor serve them, for I am the Lord your God, and I'm a jealous God. Now, he told them that in Exodus chapter 20, right? He meant that. These are commandments. God is commanding them not to do this. He's not asking, you know, if y'all, you know, try not to make any image and then, you know, adore it and worship it and stuff like that. And try to bow down to it. Try not to do that. You know, if you can. If you can't, don't worry about it. No, that ain't what God's saying. This is like a police officer giving you a direct order to move off of this corner. Because if you know, if he's telling you that, he mean it and you got to do it. It's not an option. Right? It's a direct order. And that's what God was doing. This was a direct order. Don't make any graven images of anything, of any likeness of anything that is in heaven or in the earth. That's a direct order. That's a commandment from God. That's what he told them. Chapter 32, the children of Israel was in the wilderness. Moses, God was using Moses to lead them through the wilderness. Moses was their GPS on how to get out into that wilderness to get into to get into Canaan. And the reason why Moses was their GPS, because God was Moses' GPS on how to get through that, right? So they knew that God was leading Moses and they were supposed to follow Moses at that time, right? So Moses now goes up into the mountain with God and he spends 40 days and 40 nights in there because he's communicating with God. God is talking with him. God is revealing things to him about things that happened before he was born, before his parents was born, before his great-grandparents was born, all the way to the beginning of time. You know, God revealed these things to him and he reveals it to us. This is how we have the book of Genesis, Exodus, Leviticus, Numbers, and Deuteronomy. Now, so he was up there communicating with God. He was up there hanging out with God. But the people down at the bottom in the wilderness, they can't go up to the mountain. Only God, only Moses could go up there. But the people in the wilderness was trying to figure out, man, what is, they got impatient. They trying to figure out what is taking Moses so long. He's taking too long. We got to get out of here. We want to get to the Canaan. We want to get into our, to the land of milk and honey. So what they did was they went to complain to Aaron. And look what Aaron tell him. Look what Aaron do. Look here, verse, we're in Exodus 32, Marie, 1 through 10. I'm trying to speed through it. That's why I'm talking fast. It says, and when the people saw that Moses delayed to come down out of the mountain, the people gathered themselves together unto Aaron and said unto him, up, make unto us gods which shall go before us. For as this Moses, the man that brought us up out of the land of Egypt, we know not what has become of him. We don't know where yet. We don't know what happened to him. Verse 2, and Aaron said unto them, Aaron, this is Moses' brother, break off the golden earrings which are in the ears of your wives, of your sons, and of your daughters, and bring them unto me. And all the people broke off the golden earrings which were in their ears and brought them unto Aaron. So Aaron got a whole bunch of gold earrings from all these thousands and thousands and thousands of Hebrews that just been released out of prison. Out of the slavery. Look what he gonna do with that. He gonna melt it down. Verse four. And he received them at his hand, and look what he did. And fashioned it with a graven tool. Now, see, God already told him, don't make any graven image. And look what he's getting ready to do. He fashioned it with a graven tool after he had made a molten calf. And they said, these be the gods, O Israel, which brought thee out of the land of Egypt. And when Aaron saw it, he built an altar before it. And Aaron made a proclamation and said, tomorrow is the feast of the Lord. And they rose up early on the morrow and offered burnt offerings and brought peace offerings. And the people sat down to eat to drink and to rose up to play. They're having a party. After they done sit here and made this molten image, this graven image that God said, don't do. These people start rejoicing. They started eating, drinking, playing, having a good time. They just partying. That's how we are in this world. We at nightclubs, drinking, getting high, just partying, not knowing that God is upset. God is furious because this been going on for so many generations and there's no preachers preaching them to stop and to turn away from their sin. They're not doing it and God is upset. They're sitting there having a good time, and we're about to see that God sees everything they're doing, what they just done, and we're going to see how God felt about them making this image, this cow. Verse 7, and the Lord said unto Moses, go get thee down, for thy people which thou broughtest out of the land of Egypt have corrupted themselves. God is talking with Moses. They're in a conversation. Moses can't see what's going on because he's limited. We're limited to only see what's right before us. But God sees all things, right? And God, while he's talking to Moses, he's looking at what the children of Israel is doing. And God is upset. And he's telling Moses, you know what? Okay, we're going to stop this meeting. The meeting's adjourned. It's over with. I don't want to talk no more. Get up. Go back down there. Because the children of Israel have corrupted themselves. How did they corrupt themselves? By doing the very same thing that God said don't do. God said don't make any graven image of any likeness of anything that is in heaven or in earth. They made an image of a cow in the likeness of a cow that is something here on the earth. And God said don't do that. And the Lord said unto Moses, go get thee down, for thy people which thou broughtest out of the land of Egypt have corrupted themselves. When you make statues and itches and images, and you start worshiping to it, and you start talking to it, and you start praying to it, you done corrupted yourself. They have turned aside quickly out of the way which I commanded them. See, he said, look how fast they turned out the way. I just told them, don't make any graven image, and look what they just did. They said, these be the gods that bring us out of the land of Egypt. They worshiping it. They adoring it. They having a party. They having a feast. He says, they have made them a molten calf, which is a cow, and have worshiped it. Another word for worship is adore. You know, you just adoring it, admiring it. Oh, love. And you telling everybody about it. Y'all standing around looking at it, taking pictures by it and stuff like that. You worshiping it. You adore it. You admire that thing. He says, and have sacrificed thereunto, and said, these be the gods of Israel which have brought thee up out of the land of Egypt. Verse 9, and the Lord said unto Moses, I have seen this people, and behold, it is a stiff-necked people. This is a stiff-necked people, right? That's like how we would say today, boy, that boy hard-headed. These people hard-headed, you know? Verse 10, now therefore let me alone that I may that my wrath may wax hot against them, and that I may consume them, and I will make of thee a great nation. Look, God was so upset. God was letting Moses know, okay, go back down, just leave me alone. I'm hot right now. I'm mad right now. I'm angry right now. I'm furious right now. I don't want to talk. I'm mad. I'm getting ready to consume them, meaning that I'm getting ready to destroy them. I'm getting ready to kill them. This is what God said. This is how God is angry about them doing the very thing that he said not to do. And they agreed that they wouldn't do it, and they did it anyway. And God got angry, and God's getting ready to destroy them. I'm showing you the character of God. When you do things that God don't like, especially we're talking about the subject of the statue right now, because we're looking at the statue like, I don't understand. See, when you don't read your Bible, you don't understand the things of God, then you don't understand why this happened. You don't know the severity in this. See, God struck that image because the whole world is the whole country, and people from all around the world is coming to this country, and they're adoring this statue of Jesus. That ain't Jesus. That ain't the Son of God. That's a statue, right? And people are adoring it. They're worshiping it. They're praying to it. They're taking pictures of it, by it, you know? And these people are praying to it, talking to it. That's not God. That's an idol. That's an image. That is idolatry. And God is against idolatry. He tell you in 1 Corinthians chapter 6, verse 9 and 10, he said, know ye not that the unrighteous shall not inherit the kingdom of God? He said, don't be deceived. And then he gives you a list, 10 things on the list of the people that's not going to make it into heaven. And idolatry is one of them. What is an idolater? A person who sit here and bow down to idols. That's what Catholic people do. How I know? I started out as Catholic. I was young. My mom was Catholic. Before she died, she became a Christian. But before, I used to go to Catholic church. And they had a church in the chapel. They had a statues all over. And they would have a kneeling bench with a pad on there. And you go to that bench and you put your knees on that bench. That's why they had a pad there, because you're supposed to be there for a little while. Why you're there for a while? Because you got your rosary and you're sitting there in front of that kneeling bench. It's either a statue of Mary or it's a statue of Jesus. And you are praying to this statue. You are praying to the Virgin Mary. You're calling her virgin, even though she had 6 kids after Jesus. We still call her a virgin. How she still holding on to that title, I don't know. We might as well call Madonna a virgin. She said like a virgin, so she's still a virgin, even though she just slept with half Hollywood. But anyway, we don't want to go there. So what I'm saying is that, and I wasn't talking about Mary, I was talking about Madonna, slept with half Hollywood. Anyway, so the thing is, what I'm saying is that, you know, I could be comical sometimes, you know, y'all bear with me. But you know what I'm saying is true. Anyway, what I'm saying is that God is upset when we bow down to statues. when we make these graven images and we put them up in the sky and we act like this is Jesus. We put this up there because we think our nation is going to be blessed because of that statue. That's a lie. America didn't need them statues back in the days, because America, before Catholics came over here and started putting up statues and all this stuff around, we were just a plain Christian country. How do I know? Because the reason why people came to this country is because they was running from the persecutions of the Catholic Church. So these were Christians that came over here that didn't want to be up under the Catholic people. The Roman Catholics back then used to kill you if you try to speak against anything they was doing. All the idiotic stuff that they was doing, like the statues and stuff like that, you spoke against them, they would kill you. So these people came over to this country, right? And they came over to this country because they was running from the persecutions of the church, right? And that's how we got this country. And then when we came to this country, a bunch of Christians came. And yes, they brought us Africans over here to help build up the country. Later on, we became united and we became free. But at the same time, God has allowed each and every one of us to come in this country because we now have embraced the Son of God. We have embraced the real Jesus, not a statue. We embraced the Son of God. We started reading our Bibles. We started preaching the Bibles. We started putting churches on every corner. And God had blessed this nation above all nations because we was right in the eyes of God. It's not because we had a Jesus statue. Other people was looking at, oh, that's a Christian country. They God is blessing them. Let's go ahead and put Jesus, make statues of Jesus, and put it in our country. And they started doing it all these other countries. Them countries been cursed. They ain't been blessed because you're going about it the wrong way. You're doing the very thing that God said don't do. Don't make any graven images. When I was a Catholic, we used to go in there, I used to be praying Hail Mary, Mother of God. And I'd be saying this repetitious prayer over and over again. And nothing ever worked for me. Nothing happened to me. Nothing. Nothing. None of my prayers were ever answered because I'm praying to a statue. I'm talking to a statue. My faith and my hope is in a statue. But your faith and hope should not be in a statue. Look what God said about these statues. Look what God said about this. Look at this. We in Psalms 115. Verse 3, he says, but our God is in the heavens. Our God is not that statue, Jesus. That's not our God. Our God, he's in the heavens, right? He had done whatsoever he pleased. Look at verse 4. Their idols are silver and gold, the work of men's hands. You know, some of these idols are made out of gold. Some of them is made out of silver. And these are the work of man's hands. That statue that you saw in Brazil that got struck 2 times, that's the work of a man's hand. God ain't created that. God ain't made that. God ain't designed that. God ain't fashioned that. Man did that. And people are worshiping the things that man made, right? It says in verse 5, look what he says now. He said, they have mouths, but they speak not. Eyes have they, but they see not. They have ears, but they hear not. Noses have they, but they smell not. Look what he says. He said, verse 5, they have mouths, but they speak not. They got a mouth. You talk to it, it ain't going to talk back to you. Why? Because it's a statue. But people go in these chapels and these churches, and they talk to these statues as though this statue can hear you. He got ears, but he can't hear. He got a mouth, but he can't speak back to you. He says, verse 6, they have ears, but they hear not. Noses have they, but they smell not. Verse 7, they have hands, but they handle not. Feet have they, but they walk not. Yeah, they got feet. You could tell them, oh, please, Mary, go tell Jesus this is it. That statue ain't going nowhere. It ain't moving. That statue of Mary ain't moving nowhere. It got feet, but it ain't going nowhere. It can't run and go take no message to nobody. Right? But they walk not. Neither speak they, but through their throat. Verse 8, he says, they that make them are like unto them. He said, they that make them, Paul called them idols in the book of, I think it's in the book of Acts, but I know it's in the New Testament. Paul called those idols dumb idols, right? And what he's saying here in verse 8, they that make them are dumb, just like them. He says, so is everyone that trusted in them. People trust in these statues. Look what he said in verse 9. O Israel, trust thou in the Lord. Don't trust in that statue. I'm talking to that statue. You got a statue in your house, take it outside and smash it up. God don't like that. You cursing yourself. God don't like that. Now, we don't need no statues of Mary in our house or statues of Mary outside of our house. That ain't no rabbit foot. That ain't no good luck charm. That's how we treating it. We treating it like it's a rabbit foot. And rabbit foot ain't nothing but the devil's gimmicks. You know? So the reason why I'm showing you this, because I want you to know how God feels about stature. I know in this world it seems like it's okay. It seems like it's all right. Everybody's doing it. And we sometimes are tricked into thinking that's why God is blessing this country, because of it. That is not why God has blessed this country. He has blessed this country because we accepted Jesus Christ as our Lord and Savior, and we've been following him. But this nation have turned away from him. And I don't know if you're watching the news, but this nation is not as blessed as it once was. It's not. It's a lot of things that are happening. That stuff you've seen in Ohio, the stuff that's going on in Florida, the stuff that's going on in California. Man, I'm telling you, God has left the building. And when God leaves the building, all type of chaos can happen and will happen. I'm doing this video to wake people, to wake them up, that when things, the things that are happening in this world today, especially America, is the act of God. Why is God reacting? Because he's angry. Why is he angry? Because we're sinning against God and we're not repenting. That's why. Show you one more thing before we get out of here. I know this video might be a little long, but I got to show you this one. Look at 1 Kings. I want to show you the difference. 1 Kings chapter 15 verse 9, it talks about a king named Asa. His father, the Bible said that his father did things that was evil in the eyes of God. God was upset with Asa's father. But his father died because God took his life. So then now, I told you how kings did it back then. Once a king dies, his son automatically becomes the next king. So Asa, look at this. And in verse 9, and in the 20th year of Jeroboam, king of Israel, reigned Asa over Judah. So Asa was the king of Judah. And 41 years reigned in Jerusalem. So he was a king for 41 years. Not just no 4-year term that we do in America and then another 4-year term. And that's it. You can't do number run 2 terms. Only 8 years and that's it. No. He was king for 41 years. Now listen to this. Verse 10. And 41 years reigned in Jerusalem. And his mother name was Micah. I don't know if I'm pronouncing that. And the daughter of Abishalom. I don't know if I'm pronouncing that right. Verse 11. And Asa did that which was right in the eyes of the Lord as David his father. So Asa had a reputation. Look what it's saying now. Because all these things are written for our learning and for our examples. Asa did that which was right in the eyes of the Lord. So Asa got a good report. So now I want to understand, okay, so he did things that was right in the eyes of God. I want to know what it is that he did that was right so that I could start doing the same things that he did that was right. Because the same way he pleased the Lord, I want to please the Lord the same way. He says that Asa did that which was right in the eyes of the Lord as did David his father. Verse 12. And he took away the Sodomites out of the land and removed all the idols that was in his father had made, that his father had made. And look at this. It says he took away the Sodomites. Y'all know what Sodomites is? Sodomite, look right there, definition. It says a person who engages in sodomy. What is sodomy? Sexual intercourse involving anal or oral copulation. I just showing you what sodomy is. Sodomites, because we need to know the definition of what it's saying. He's talking about sodomites. He removed the sodomites. Sodomites is a person who does sodomy. And sodomy is what you just read. I don't even want to repeat that. That's homosexuality, right? Because remember, God destroyed Sodom and Gomorrah because of the deeds that was over there. And what was the deeds over there? What you just read about sodomy. That right there. That's sodomy. That's what they was doing over there. That's what God don't like. God don't like that. Yeah, you get it raw and uncut on this news right here, on this channel right here, raw and uncut, right? That's what God don't like. And we didn't, that's the names they used to call them, but we have watered it down to make it seem like it's okay. We didn't change it from sodomites to, oh, he's homosexual, oh, he's gay, you know. Gay didn't always mean that. Gay meant that a person was happy. We didn't rob the meaning and gave him gay showing him that he's happy in his sins, I guess. But I just want to show you how God felt about that. I want to show you how what God did, how God was pleased with the guy for what he did. And what did he do? It says in verse, give me a second. It says, and he took, verse 12, and he took away the sodomites out of the land. So the sodomites, the homosexuals that was in the land, the one that his father allowed to be in the land, all of them around, and now they, you know, because you allowed them to be there, they're going to start, you see what they're doing today. They want to start doing drag queens and bring them to the class to dance before your kids. They're pushing it on you to accept them and all that. His father allowed them to do all that, but when Asa got in charge, he told every last one of them, pack your bags. I don't know where you're going, but you're getting out of here. You ain't going to be living here. You ain't going to be corrupting our children. You ain't going to have our children confused, thinking they could grow up and be just like you. No, you're getting out of here. And that's how God felt about it. And men of God, that's how men of God were supposed to feel about it, right? So it says, and he took away the sodomites out of the land. But that's not what this message is about. And removed all the idols that his father had made. That's what we're talking about. We're talking about that statues, which is a graven image, which is an idol. His father also not only had the homosexuals all around the land and didn't remove them, he allowed them to be there, but he also had idols everywhere, statues everywhere, right? But when Asa, after his father died, when he came into power, when he came into the palace, when he came into the White House, as we would say, he changed stuff, because now he's making things right in the eyes of God, and God is pleased with him. Verse 12 says, and he took away the sodomites out of the land, and he removed all the idols that his father had made. And also, look at this, and also Mesha, which is his mother, even her he removed for being queen, because she had made an idol in the grove. And Asa destroyed her idol and burnt it in the brook of Kidron. Look at this. He came into power. He started changing everything. First of all, he told all the homosexuals, pack your bags and leave. You're getting out of this land. I don't want you corrupting this land. I don't want our little kids thinking it's okay to be gay. I don't want our little sons thinking that we could be grow up and be girls. I don't want our little daughters thinking that they could grow up and be boys. I don't want everybody referring to each other as he, they, she, and all that old crap. Right? So he said, y'all getting out of here. Y'all ain't poisoning our community. Y'all ain't transforming other people's lives. This ain't happening. Men ain't finna walk around here with dressing high heels and wear makeup. We ain't finna see that. So y'all get up out of this land. That's the first thing he did. The second thing he did was he removed all the idols out of the house, because he understood these were graven images. God don't like this. God is upset about this. He want to make this country. This country was getting blessed. The country was getting cursed because of the things that his father was doing. Things weren't going right in the country because of the things that his father was allowing. So when he came in power, he made it right with God. So his mama now, who his father was king, so naturally his mama's a queen. And in this palace, just like the White House, you know, when man become president, he goes into the White House and he brings his wife with him. So the wife and him both shares the White House, right? So now this king, his dad, was the king and his mama was the queen. So of course she stayed in the house. But when he became king, I'm sure the mother said, well, you know, my son is now in power. I'm still going to be in the house. You know, I'm still going to be the queen in the palace. Nah. He said, Mom, pack your bags. You leave it out of here too. And I destroyed all the idols you had, because she made an idol. She put an idol in there. And because she did that, he removed his mom and he threw all her idols out and he smashed them and he even burnt them. Because he understood that the condition of the country that they're in right now is because of these statues, of these images, because we have sinned against God, and he wanted to make it right. So, with that being said, today, if you didn't already know that, you learned today the real reason why that lightning hit that statue. It hit that statue because that was an act of God. It wasn't an accident. It was the act of God. God directed his arrows, which was the lightning, at that statue. The first time he hit the finger, this time he hit the face. He hit the face. I want you to remember that for the next video we're going to talk about. He hit the face, you know, and that means something with God. He hits the head. He's upset with this. He's upset with the people down here on this earth that is looking up to that statue instead of looking up to God, instead of looking up to his son, Jesus Christ, who died and shed his blood for us. We should not be looking up to a statue. We should not be talking to a statue. We should not be trusting in a statue. We should not be adoring a statue, taking pictures with a statue and showing everybody, look, I was with Jesus today. Nah, that's, you think it's funny, but God don't think that's funny. God is upset about that. And God is revealing, he's expressing his power, his anger of how he feel from heaven about this statue. He's letting us know. And we ought not to overlook that. We ought to examine that. And man, they need to tear that statue down. Every statue of Jesus and Mary all throughout this world, God, they people need to tear it down. Need to shoot it, to tear it down. Like they shot at that balloon and brought it down, they need to go up there and start shooting at all these statues and bring them down. That's a first step on pleasing God. That's what will make this world, help make this world be in a better place. So, I got another video coming up. It's dealing with lightning. And God, this also was an act of God. Y'all ain't gonna like me after this video. When I talk about this video, some of y'all are gonna agree with me. Some of y'all are gonna say, yeah, you know what, I agree with that, you're right. But some of y'all, it's not gonna agree with me. You ain't gonna like what I say about it. So I want y'all to stay tuned for that video. I'll be doing that video as soon as I get a chance. Y'all know I'm working. I'm working right now. I'm about to go load this vehicle. But I just want y'all to know, man, that God is upset. He is. God is upset, man. Does not like what's going on down here on this earth. That made God very upset. So I want you to watch this preacher. I got a preacher coming up. I'm going to leave the link below where you can watch the whole video, but I'm going to show this. And you know, some of y'all might get mad at the preacher, man, but I'm going to tell you something. That preacher, don't just listen to him. Don't just listen to him. Look at what he's saying. What? Read them scriptures. Them scriptures that he put up with it. Read them scriptures. And he gonna read the scriptures, then he gonna talk about it. Follow him in the scriptures. And you'll see if he tells the truth, like I do. You know, like I do. When I preach a preacher, man, I go to look at the scriptures and see if it tie in. But what he's saying make a lot of sense. And then what he's saying about these statues, man, I agree with everything he's saying in this particular video. I really do. So, yeah, I'm about to load this car, y'all. Get on this road. I got to start working and picking up these cars. Anyway, I love y'all, man. God bless you. Thank you for hanging out with me. I got another video coming up, probably in about another week. I got another video coming up. It's dealing with lightning. Matter of fact, I'm doing 3 videos dealing with lightning. I'm trying to wake y'all up to understand the acts of God and why God is doing the things he's doing. This is the first video. This is act of God part 1. I'm going to do an act of God part 2. We ain't talking about statues now. We talking about a whole new situation that God struck from heaven. And we doing an act of God part 3. We ain't going to talk about that one either. The third one is just going to be these are whole new different subjects. These are subjects that you need to see and we need to discuss. Anyway, God bless you guys. I love you guys. And y'all be safe out there. Get right with God if you ain't right with God. God bless you guys.
Amen. That little statue that you think is Jesus standing in your house.
Standing there. That's right.
You got Jesus. Mm. An image supposed to be Jesus. Mm. And a statue supposed to be the blessed mama.
Amen.
Mary. On your lawn.
Amen.
That's garbage.
That's right.
You set that stuff out on trash day.
That's right.
That's garbage.
Amen. Go ahead, go ahead. Go ahead, go ahead.
Now,
amen.
I know I'm going to get mail for this, and I really don't care.
Yes, you will. That's right.
You all right? Now listen.
Amen.
It may be funny, but consider this. In some areas, you got the whole island bowing to this.
That's right.
In some areas, you got almost a whole country.
Amen.
Bowing to this.
That's right.
In some areas, you got almost an entire state.
Amen.
And this is what you folk be doing. Some of you, your loved ones are sick in the hospital and all that stuff. Amen. You go right down to the chapel in the hospital.
Right.
Where this image is there.
That's right.
And talk to this image.
Amen.
Now, let's see, does images hear or see
Amen.
Or smell?
Amen.
Let's get some Bible.
Psalms 115.
Listen, follow me in the Bible. Give chapter and verse.
Psalms 115 and begin at verse 4.
Listen.
Their idols are silver and gold.
Their idols are silver and gold.
The work of men's hands.
This is the work of men's hands.
They have mouths.
They what?
They have mouths. But they speak not. Amen. They have mouths, but they speak not.
Hail Mary.
Speak not.
Hail Mary.
Speak not. They have
Hail Mary.
Speak not. Have mouths, but speak
I must
not.
Be doing something wrong.
Amen.
Because you people out there saying, she healed you.
That's right.
That's what they said, didn't
That's
it?
Right.
You people out there, you out there saying, she healed you.
Amen.
Listen at the book. Oh, this is good.
They have mouths.
They have what?
They have mouths. But
mouths.
But they speak not.
Can't talk.
Eyes have they. Eyes have they, but they see not. Amen. Eyes have they, but they see not. Amen.
Can't see me. Tell me how they seeing you praying.
That's right.
God say they have eyes and can't see.
See
how did they see you praying?
Amen. Amen.
Now my haters will say, you're disgusting. All right. Now come and tell me how did she see you praying.
That's right. That's right.
Listen.
They have ears.
They have ears.
But they hear not.
So if the Bible said they have ears and don't hear you.
Don't hear.
Why are you talking to it?
That's right.
Why are you down there, Hail Mary, the mother of God? This ain't nobody's mama.
That's right.
This is nobody's mama.
Amen.
It is idolatry.
That's what it is. That's right.
Come on, I want to work through the Old Testament and kill idolatry.
Kill it. That's right.
Listen.
They have ears.
They have ears.
But they hear not.
Can't hear. Can you answer my prayer?
Amen. Have ears.
How long you been holding that?
Hear not. Amen. They have ears, but they hear not.
I think you need a new paint job.
They have ears.
What?
But they hear not.
So now there's a religion that got thousands of innocent victims trusting in this clay.
That's right.
You're saying this is God's mother.
Amen.
You saying this. That little image on the cross is Jesus.
Right.
Now, we're going to test your image, your little image, Jesus.
Amen.
And we're going to test what you consider is the Blessed Mother.
Blessed Mother.
Is that all right?
Amen.
I wish I had something hard.
Amen.
Like a hammer.
Yeah.
If you got a hammer, get me a hammer.
Amen.
I want to see that this got power.
That's right.
You don't mind, do you?
That's right.
I want to see dude got power.
Amen.
Someone said, don't do that. Why not?
Why not?
Don't you fight for her. Let her fight for herself.
Go ahead. Go ahead.
Let her fight for herself.
Go ahead.
They're supposed to be like a god.
Amen.
They said she is above all women.
All
but the
women.
Bible said blessed among.
Among women.
Not above.
That's right.
Among.
Among women.
Women.
That's right.
That's a big difference.
Amen.
I'm doing this to show people how through deception of the devil, who used the Bible as a front, the name Jesus as a front, Jesus has been misrepresented for years.
Amen.
So folks frown upon me when I do something like this.
Amen.
So I know you're going to call and cuss me out and all that, but
oh,
I tell
yeah.
you what you do. Just send Mary down here.
Amen.
Or do we have her? Now, this is pretty hard. It's pretty hard. Is that right? Now,
amen.
This image supposed to be the Savior.
Right.
This image supposed to be Christ. Listen, people,
that's
when
right.
these people got this on a churchyard, in houses, in prison cells, and this is what they're doing to it.
That's right.
Your family is sick. And you crying, oh, Mary, Mary, please, oh, Mary, help me. Mary, help me.
Amen.
And then some of you liars, some of you liars say you saw this crying.
Yes.
Am I right?
That's right.
You said you saw her crying.
Amen.
They said they saw the statues crying to Italy. You saw it somewhere in America, a
yeah.
crying statue.
Crying.
Now, if I hit her, she should cry.
That's right.
Is that right?
Go ahead, go
she
ahead.
She should cry. If this got power.
Amen.
Something's wrong.
That's right.
Mary ain't did nothing yet.
Not yet.
Mary, she gonna have to do something. Can you hear what I'm talking?
Amen.
Oh, yes. She gonna have to do something.
Amen.
My viewers.
Amen.
If you've seen that this statue couldn't even stop a hammer.
That's right. That's right.
Many of you bowing to this little image on the cross. He done lost his head. The scriptures have never.
Amen.
Instruct us to bow to idols.
That's right. That's right. Never.
But yet you Christians.
That's right.
Who will retaliate against my actions.
Amen.
Wherein you got to say amen because we shall bow to none another.
Right.
Every knee shall bow.
That's right.
Every tongue shall confess that Jesus Christ is Lord, unto the glory of God the Father.
That's right. That's right.
We don't pray to this.
Go ahead.
Are you listening? So you down there praying.
Amen.
Look at it. Look at the image. Nothing.
Nothing.
Nothing. Nothing. Nothing.
Watching this channel, hey, don't get mad. Now, this is not my car. So I know you some people get mad when they see me in a nice car. I'm at work. This is what I do at work. I'm driving this car to put it on the truck. God bless you guys and thank you guys for watching.
We're sending this one out to the Lord. We thank you and we know we need to pray. It's all the blessings that are good, they come from above. And once again, we want to say thank you to the Lord.